Hi, I'm Brendan Burns from Microsoft Azure, and we're going to talk about Kubernetes and configuration management. When you think about configuration management, it's helpful to think about the problem that we're trying to solve. When people first define their pod and their container image, I think they often think, well, you know what, configuration can just be a part of the container image that I deploy. But I think it's useful to think of the pod and the container image just like you would think of a function in a programming language. And just like a function has parameters, you should think about a configuration for your application providing the parameters for your container image. The reason for this is because you want to create images that are general purpose, that are useful in a variety of scenarios. You may have different configurations in a canary environment where you're testing a particular configuration. As you deploy to a worldwide configuration, you may want to parameterize your image with different languages, different images, all sorts of different small variations that you want while still using the same build, the same continuous delivery to define the image itself. Fortunately, in Kubernetes, there's a resource to represent this, and it's known as a ConfigMap. A ConfigMap resource is a collection of key value pairs. And those key value pairs can be something like, you know, a language of ENUS, so really just string-string pairs. Or they might also be something like a properties file in a traditional Java application, and where the configuration value is actually the value of the file itself. Now, when you think about consuming this config map after it's been created inside of the Kubernetes API server, you can mount that config map as a volume into the pod itself. And then once you create the volume associated with the pod, you can then mount it into your container at a particular directory. And depending on whether your config map is representing a single file or a collection of files, you either map it into a directory where each file becomes a subfile within that directory, or it maps to a specific file in the context of the container. Now, that's useful for configuration that is a file. But what about configuration that is just a simple key value pair? Well, in that context, you can also use environment variables and point those environment variables at your configuration map, such that in your code, you can say something like get env and gain access to the configuration that you stored into the config map. Now, the question that you should have is, well, what about something like a password? It might seem like a password is a configuration value as well. But in fact, because passwords and other kinds of secrets are, while conceptually configuration, something that you want to be very careful about the management of and possibly use different access control and different sorts of settings, Kubernetes actually treats config and secrets as separate objects, even though they look and operate largely the same. So when you're thinking about configuring your secrets, you should use a Kubernetes secret instead of a config map for storing certificates, database passwords, and all that sort of stuff. Now, the next interesting question is, how should you think about rolling out configuration in Kubernetes? It's often been said that configuration is code, and it really should be treated as such. You could easily have an application that is totally healthy, provide it with a new configuration, and cause that application to crash. So in that context, you want to be able to perform a rollout of your configuration, just like you would perform a rollout of your application. Fortunately, you can do this. So you may have your application v1 with ConfigMap and you have this defined in a deployment. Well, if you keep the container image the same, but you change the configuration map that's mapped as a volume into your container, so let's say we change this instead to be config2. Well, it turns out that actually the deployment engine is going to notice that change and actually perform the same kind of rolling update that it does if you change the container image. And so in particular, if in the template spec for your deployment, you change the configuration to point to a new configuration object. And these are configuration map resources, CFG1 and CFG2, that you've already created. So you have two different config map resources. If you change the config map in the specification of your application, Kubernetes will actually start doing the same kind of rolling upgrade. And eventually, you'll get to a world, assuming everything happens correctly, where you've rolled out that new configuration with proper health testing, with all of the things that you would associate with an image rollout. So the deployment API actually makes it very easy for you to manage the deployment of new configurations, just like you manage the deployment of new images. And you should absolutely run them through the same kind of continuous validation and testing that you do with an image prior to even getting to the rollout stage in the context of Kubernetes. The final piece that you should be thinking about is templating. So when you think about configuration, it's great to create these config maps, but in many cases, you want the configuration to be largely the same, but a little bit different depending on your environment. So you might have a high-level template and two configurations, east and west, that extend from that template and add some extra value. When you're thinking about templating and configuration management in that context, a tool like Helm can provide a lot of templating capabilities, and you can find out more information at helm.sh. Hope that gives you an early intro into why you might be motivated to separate your application and configuration, and how you can use config maps to represent configuration information, bring them into your containers, and then ultimately roll them out to your applications.